Imagining what the fugitives might look like after more than 10 days is the job of a forensic artist.
I'm looking at what I consider are immediate ways to disguise a face.
Gil Zamora received training from the FBI and has been doing these kind of sketches for 20 years.
You're a former police officer and a forensic artist. Mm-hmm. When you look at this case in New York, do you think that these guys have totally altered their identities?
Well, I would say that's probably a very good possibility. My experience has been that when they're out and they're trying to get away, they're going to do everything they can to disguise themselves and make sure that nobody recognizes them.
Zamora is not involved with the New York case, but we asked him to come up with some additional ways the fugitives might have changed their appearance. First, Richard Matt. Here's the original, and this is the altered creation.
This person could probably evade capture.
I would say so, at least initially, definitely. I gave him what I considered a full beard. There's a possibility he could be dyeing his hair.
And with some eyewear, it's clear the public would have a difficult time recognizing him.
Well, I think they would think twice. I wouldn't say they would immediately pick him out.
Now, David Sweat. This is the original mug. And this is how Zamora imagined what he could do.
Changing the clothing and extending the facial hair, and then also adding some eyewear to kind of distract people from looking at their eyes as well.
Hair on both the face and head, he says, are the two main ways in which men could change their appearance. Just like Harrison Ford did in The Fugitive.
I didn't kill my wife! I don't care!
These real-life fugitives could be doing simple things to their faces, and it's quite possible no one would spot them, at least not immediately. That's why all these photos could be instructive, or maybe even instrumental, in cracking the case.
I think anything that keeps the public aware and keep this case alive for people to be on the lookout is extremely valuable.
Dan Simon, CNN, San Jose, California.